hello again, guys. Time for another AMA. AMA is Ask Me Anything, and they're questions that I receive on the ZTalk forum from you guys. I put them together, and when I got a bunch, I do a video. So please, go on to the ZTalk forum and ask your questions. There's a section there for questions. And it'd be great if you subscribe to this channel for me, and we can continue to do these AMAs and answer your questions and kind of give you a concise understanding of whatever it is you're asking. So subscribe and join, and that would be great. I would appreciate that. So now for the first question. It was sent in by Zed, and he wants to know if there are other pentode preamp tubes that he can use for position V1 on his Z28 Mark II. Well, that is an EF86, and it does have a kind of a unique pinout. So you kind of have to use an EF86. Now, there is another number for the EF86 that you might find, and it is the 6267. And that is kind of the American mil-spec number for an EF86. If you're familiar with tubes and military tubes and all the different grading of tubes, you'll see that four-digit numbered tubes generally are the military tubes that they give that designation or number to. An example of that is the 6201. That's a 12AT7. In military terms, it's called a 6201. The same with a 6189. That's a 12AU7. So, when you get with the 12AUs and the 12ATs and the 12AXs, it can get a little bit confusing. So the military, to make things concise, give it numbers. So to answer your question, Zed, yeah, if you find a nice 6267, that is an EF86, and that will plug in. Now, just for a point to make, the 5879 will not plug into that socket. The pinout of a 5879 is different than an EF86. So the pins and configuration of the wiring of the socket has to be different for a 5879. So please don't try to plug one of those in to an EF86 socket or vice versa. Try to plug an EF86 in a 5879 socket. Okay, my next question is a pretty cool one. It's from Bubs42, and he asks, have you ever thought of making a ZBest 210 cabinet? And I thought about that, and I said, wow, that does make some sense. And some of the reasons that it makes sense is this. Shipping has gone through the roof. If you guys are familiar with it, if you, buy and flip amps or whatever, you know that shipping costs have gone crazy in the past couple of years. So to send a ZBest cab with its size and weight is extremely expensive. I don't know how people can send 412 cabs. I mean, they got to cost $500 or $600 to ship. And a ZBest isn't far behind that. Even though I use the lighter weight wood and the ZBest isn't that heavy, it's still dimensional weight that UPS goes by. So the box is big, it takes up room in the truck. So whether it's heavy or not, it's at a premium price. So by making a 210 ZBest, that might be nice. It'll be smaller, easier to carry, lighter. And if it uses my Z10s, the Dr. Z Z10s, which are pretty big magneted 10s that to my ear sound a lot like a 12. I mean, they're a big sounding 10. That might make for a great cabinet. So I did approach my cabinet builder and I asked them about it, and we're in the process of trying to put together a prototype. So who knows? Might see a 210 ZBest cab come. Thanks, Bubs. I've got a question here from Bakelite. And Bakelite says that he's interested in getting a Stang-Ray, but wants to know, is there going to be a newer Stang-Ray? Should I wait until you release something new, or should I look for a used Stang-Ray on the market? That's a good question, because basically I do have an updated Stang-Ray, and it's called the X-Ray. and it's available today. And it kind of combines the Stang-Ray's nice clean sparkle with the DB4's kind of thicker distortion. And then also updated the Stang-Ray in the sense that I added an effects loop, a tube-driven effects loop, and a post-phase inverter master volume, and also a half power switch. So you can kind of get that sound at a lower level or a higher level, more clean, less clean, master volume distortion. So all of that is part of the X-Ray. I think you'll enjoy it. If you're looking for a Stang-Ray, maybe wait and pick up an X-Ray. I have a question from Skylark. And what Skylark would like to know is a little bit about the Z80. And he's asking, is the Z80 a push-pull output configuration? Or is it four single-ended EL34s in a single configuration? To answer your question, Skylark, it is push-pull. Okay, so it is a push-pull configuration, just like most of your amps are today. But it is individually cathode biased. So you say, well, you know, what's the advantage of that? Well, there is quite an advantage to having single bias resistors for each of the EL34s. No matter how well you get a matched set of tubes, they're not going to be perfectly matched, number one, out of the box. And number two, as they age, they start to drift. So if you have just one bias resistor to take care of those four EL34s, what's going to happen is as they increase or decrease in gain, that bias resistor is going to generate a bias voltage. It's going to kind of be an average to feed all four of them. So it's not going to be the specific bias voltage that that individual tube needs. It's going to be an average. So by having four individual bias resistors, as these tubes start to change, the resistor is going to adjust. And it's going to always be self-biasing and be a perfect bias for that tube. So as time goes on, they never kind of drift and change and get a little dirtier or maybe not quite as clean or as loud. They stay as they did the first day you got them out of the box. And that's the advantage of having four individual cathode resistors in a push-pull configuration. So there's a positive and a negative. Just like you see, there's a phase inverter, so it takes and flips the phase. So you've got that coming out of the output transformer to your speaker. Okay, I have another Z80 question, and it comes from David Dorian, 5349. And David wants to know, you know, there are times when I want to use my Z80, but I would like to use it with a single 12, not the 212. I don't need as much volume and spread as a 212 gives me. is there a 112 that I can use? Well, you know, you had mentioned in your question about a El Nico Cream, the 90-watt El Nico Cream speaker. And all I can say is, you know, I believe that will work, though, David, I've never tried it. I never did really hook up a Z80 to an El Nico Cream 90-watt speaker to tell you definitively what I think, but I'm sure that it will work and sound good. If you like the sound of the Cream El Nico, well, you'll probably like it connected to the Z80. But I will say one speaker that I tried that Frankie brought into the shop, a speaker that he had, and that was a Celestion Redback 150-watt speaker. And boy, that sounded really good with the Z80 as a single 12. It certainly has the power handling capability to take everything the Z80 can give it. Keeps it clean, keeps it clear, and still has that Celestion-y kind of sound to it that we're accustomed to hearing through the Z80. So there's two examples of 112s you can try. I'm sure there's others, but those are the two that come to my head right now. Okay, David. Thanks, man. Okay, I got a question from Rick, R-I-K, part of the Z-Talk forum. And he wants to know if Karman Ghias in the future will come with post-phase inverter master volume, as they did in the 35th anniversary 110 release that we did. And my answer is yes. Simply put, all of the Ghias now that we build in 2024, be them heads, 112 combos, 210 combos, or 110 combos, will have post-phase inverter master volume. So they'll have the same front panel, a great addition, even though, you know, it's a low wattage amp. People say, well, why do you need a master volume? It's only 15 watts or so. But, you know, at home, in your studio, it's great to be able to get a nice driven sound at a very low volume level so you're not disrupting everybody else. And you can get a nice recorded sound. In my music room where I practice, I have a master volume Karman Ghia with a 110 extension cabinet. And it's perfect. I get my sound. I don't disrupt everybody. My wife doesn't come in and tell me to turn down. So yes, all the Karman Ghias will have the post-phase inverter master volume, Rick. Okay, so remember to submit your questions to the Z-Talk forum. I'll kind of peruse them. When I get a few, we'll do another video. So that's where you'll see me again in this AMA. So join the Z-Talk forum, subscribe to our YouTube, and we'll see you the next time, okay? Thanks.